Le Chatelier's principle states that when one perturbs a system at equilibrium, then the system will try to offset that perturbation. For example, if you deplete the concentration of a solute reactant, then the system will react in the inverse direction, from right to left, to regenerate some of the lost reactant. The very same thing would occur if we increase the pressure of a gaseous product, though this time the system would react in the inverse direction so as to decrease the amount of that gaseous product. What happens if you increase the pressure exerted upon a system at equilibrium, such that the partial pressures of the gaseous reactants and products are simultaneously increased? Le Chatelier's principle makes it clear that the system will try to decrease the pressure so as to offset the perturbation. How it does this, however, requires some thought. Pressure arises from the gaseous products, so to decrease the pressure, one must decrease the number of gas particles. If there are no gaseous reactants or products, or if we have the same number of gas molecules on each side of the balanced equation, then there is little the system can do to offset the perturbation. But if one side of the balanced equation has fewer gas molecules, the system will respond by reacting towards that side. Finally, if by chance you increase the total pressure by adding gas molecules that are not involved in the reaction in any way, then they have no influence on our equilibrium, and nothing occurs. As for the effect of temperature, we will do something that we should not normally do, and equate heat, a form of energy measurable in joules, to temperature, a fundamentally different quantity measured in Kelvin. Also, we must view heat as a reactant or product. In an endothermic reaction, it is a reactant as heat enters the system. In an exothermic reaction, it is a product as heat leaves the system. Once we do this, we treat heat like any other reactant or product. If we increase the temperature, we increase the heat, so the system will thus react in such ways so as to reduce the heat. For endothermic reactions, it reacts towards the right. For exothermic reactions, it will react towards the left. If we decrease the temperature, we decrease the heat, and the system reacts so as to increase the heat. Endothermic reactions now react towards the left, and exothermic reactions towards the right.